How's it going, YouTube? Oxy here, and welcome back. So I'm back with some more prey news. Of course, the Predator prequel, or so we thought, coming this in less than 2 weeks, August 5th, on Hulu, of course, here in the U.S. I did find out it is on Disney Plus, but in the U.K. So here it's only on Hulu. But yeah, just want to talk about a little bit more news that has come out about it, little bits and pieces. So the first main one is that for the since hearing about the movie, right, the when it was under its working name Skulls, right, and all that, and finding out it was a Predator movie, we all were under the assumption this is a prequel to the first movie, right, that it's the first one, because the movie takes place 1719, so 4 years after the pistol engraving, right, from Predator 2, the Antonio something 1715, so maybe it's only 4 years after. But yeah, the movie takes place in 1719, of course, during with we're following our character Naru and the Comanche tribe, which is a real Native American tribe, which the movie will play in obviously English audio or Comanche, so you could have subtitles, which is really cool. That's cool representation, you know, like to Native Americans. But I am definitely gonna watch it in both. But yeah, prequel. It takes place 1719, so as of yet, it is the earliest we're seeing a Predator, right, in a movie time period. But the director Dan, I hope I'm pronouncing it right, it's with the T. he has clarified that, no, it isn't meant to be like, oh, this is like a prequel to this first movie specifically. The way he explained it is, yes, it's set basically like 300-ish years in the past, but this specific Predator that we're seeing, the feral Predator, it is the alien's first time on Earth. So he is like inexperienced with humans. Yes, he's been to other planets, right? Other, like, hunting other aliens. But specifically to Earth, it is his first time arriving. So it's like, yeah, it's not directly tied to, like, any previous movie. Because that's the cool thing about Predators. It's like an anthology series. It always involves, obviously, the titular alien. But each movie is kind of its own thing. Yeah, they can connect, right, in ways. Or you know, similar, like, oh, like how Predator 2 references the first one. Like, there was a previous attack incident in, like, Central America where the first one took place. But other than that, they're pretty self-contained stories. And this is another one. Like, and I like that idea that this is the feral Predator's first time on Earth, so he's inexperienced, which does worry me, thinking, oh, so he's gonna die, you know? And that's one thing, is like, can we get a movie where the Predator doesn't die, you know? If they're supposed to be the ultimate hunter, why do they always get bested by the humans? I mean, at least give us a tie, where there's like a moment of respect, right? And they're like, okay, and he goes a separate way. But, yeah, and again, they're out there. There is leaks of what he looks like. So I've seen what he looks like with his mask. There's a new TV spot that shows like the jaw open up and he is wearing like the skullish mask. And people are saying, oh, he looks kind of different. And again, the director talks about that. Think of this Predator as a different species, right? Because back like in the 2010 Predators with the S, in that movie, like the super predators, like the berserker and all those, they look different, right? Their heads were like more round, more ovally. This is another one that's different, and he explains it, just think of this one as from like the other hemisphere of their main planet, Yautja Prime. So I like that. I like that it is the earliest movie in the universe, but it's also introducing new things, a new predator, new that sort of thing. So I like that. I like that, as far as we know, this is like a inexperienced predator. Because, like, I'm thinking, first movie, Second movie, they were pretty, like, good. I think third one, yeah, they were hunters. The Predator, we assume. I think this might be the first one, other than AVP. Of course, in the first one, they were all Youngbloods, right? Who were hunting Xenos, and they had to prove themselves. So other than the first Alien vs. Predator, this is the first time we're getting a newbie. I think so. Hey, I could be wrong. But to my knowledge, it's the first proper time, other than Alien vs. Predator, which might be canon, or like the possibility, because in those movies, the lore is that like the Predators have been coming to Earth for millennia, like even since like the Mayans, right? Like they were worshipped as gods, and they helped essentially humanity like build pyramids, like advance technologically. Yeah, so in the Predator universe, in like this movie tying in could like make them canon, as in like, oh yeah, like in Prey's example, we're getting it in the 1700s, whereas AVP, it's like, yeah, they've been coming since forever. Because that was the thing, that was a misconception that everyone was like, oh, this is the first time of a Predator like period on Earth, where it's like, no, as the director said, it's the first time of the specific monster. It is its first time on Earth, not the species in general. So in theory, that could make both AVP movies canon to the Predator franchise. To Alien, not so much, because of Alien Covenant, Prometheus, right? With like the engineers and that sort of thing. Doesn't really work out, but that's cool. I mean, hey, Disney, AVP 3, where it at though? Or reboot it, you know? But I'm excited. Look, I hope the movie does well. Of course, it's not in theater, so stream it. Make sure to watch it 20 times. Because, of course, it's not box office. But if it does well enough, we may get a sequel. And it may get a proper theater release. Maybe they do a double feature, play both. I love that. But yeah, guys, that's it. Just explaining that this may not be a prequel after all. Let me know what you guys thought. Are you excited for the movie? Clearly, I am. And let me know, are you going to watch it in English or in Comanche with the subtitles? That's really cool that they're doing that, you know? That they're representing, like, the Native American culture, like, the tribe that they're, you know, it's in the movie. That's really cool. But, yeah, guys, if you like this type of content, I make new videos every Tuesday and Saturday. And please be sure to like, share, subscribe, hit the notification bell, all that good jazz. And as always, everyone, I've been your host, Toxie. Take care, and I'll see you next time.